getting it going, getting up, getting ready for the day.
Doing our classic Thursday morning routine.
That's what we're doing as well, you know, and actually we've been awake for hours.
Have you?
Yeah.
We've been awake for approximately 2 hours and 46 minutes.
That is good knowledge. That's
fun. And counting.
Mm. before we continue, I have a bit of a complaint about you three. Is that right?
Bring it on.
All right. Well,
we got a couple complaints for you, too. So.
Okay. Is it a sizable list for us, or is it just a couple?
Just a couple pages. Okay. Yeah, just a few pages.
Who's going first, then? Is it us?
Yeah, you
please,
go first.
You first.
All right. So here's the thing, right? I'm a single man and you're not really giving us much of a chance. That's my complaint. I'm thinking, Kevin, you leave notes for Danielle every day. Nick, you posted a beautiful memory of 1 year, not the anniversary of your wedding or anything like that, but the anniversary of the day you met your wife, which is just different level. And Joe, you obviously have to memorize all the lines from Game of Thrones or something like that to be romantic, don't you? So can you give other guys a chance? That's my complaint to you.
Not with those women, but with their own, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean,
them to shame, basically. Guess
yeah, exactly.
He's been saying that every time he sees or reads something you guys do for your lovely ladies, he's like, oh, that's what
no,
I'm
but
going
you
wrong.
Know what? We feel that way internally too. One of us will do something, the other one's like, all right, I got to step up now.
Kevin with the letter thing, I was like, really, dude?
Yeah, that was it's like so that took a minute to get over.
It's so lovely
day?
Until even, like even until like you're thinking like. I don't think I've ever written a letter
in my life.
Priyanka, actually, we saw her last night, and she said, well done, Kevin, and kind of gave Nick a look. So I knew. I was like, uh-oh.
No, that's not what happened. She said, that was so sweet, and you said, yeah, Nick, step it up. I was like, damn.
Oh, that's true. That's what happened.
That's mean.
I was trying
cold-blooded.
To make more news. So as much as we're, like, maybe throwing you under the bus and making it difficult for you, it makes it really difficult for us over here as well.
Yeah. What advice would you have for somebody like Gethin who is terminally single?
Terminally single. That's amazing.
You don't have to answer this question.
Have you started dating on the internet yet?
he's tried and he's failed.
Yeah. Join Bumble.
I found some weird sites on their mind.
Instagram?
Yeah, in DMing, is it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we're looking at your beautiful face right now.
Mm-hmm.
You're a handsome guy. Like, what?
Thanks, man.
What's wrong with you? Why can't you get a date? What's going on here? You want to talk about this? We can talk more about this.
What Gemma does is, like, she messages Gorka on Instagram. They communicate through Instagram, through love. It's a bit horrible, actually.
Through
he's
what?
He's just jealous. He's jealous, you see, because myself and Dave's loved up. I'm happily loved up. I'm about to have my first baby with my partner.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And Gethin's the only one, bless him, who's been on his own. We've tried so many times to set him up with people.
But you know what, though? I'm all about... It keeps the show dynamic, though.
Yeah.
You know, let's get real. You have new stories, new experiences.
Yes. He's also hoping that the introduction of 5G into the UK today will actually... you know, enhance his chances of finding a virtual girlfriend.
Ah, well, you know what? I'm all about online. I met my lady through Instagram, so it works.
Okay, well, thanks. I don't know how this became about me. Let's make it about Gemma for a bit. Kevin, give Gemma some advice. She's about to become a new parent, as is Gorka. What advice would you give her?
Ooh, it's very, very fun. And you just enjoy those moments when they're young, because I know that statement of like, oh, they grow up so fast. Well, they actually do. Like, I just was on FaceTime with my daughters yesterday, and my youngest looks so different in 2 weeks. It's just crazy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's hard being away from them.
Do you know what, though? They're so involved now. It was a bit of a comeback, and what a comeback it was with Sucker. They all feature, don't they, in the video, the wives and the kids as well. What a comeback that was, guys.
Thank you very much. Well, yeah, we've just been overwhelmed with the reception. It's been really incredible, so we appreciate the love.
Happiness begins. It's been a roller coaster, hasn't it, since the Disney days and back and forth and doing your own thing and coming back as a band. Is this the kind of like a new era for you as a group?
It is. You know, in addition to the album, next week we also have the documentary we did with Amazon coming out on June 4th, which really kind of tells the story of... You know, initially the intention was just to tell the story of our childhood and our upbringing into our career together in the first iteration of everything, and then how, you know, our lives are now. Me doing my solo music, Joe with DNCE, and Kevin with his family. But in the process of making that, I think we all realized we missed that magic that we had together and wanted to do it again, you know. And so you actually get to see that journey and kind of where it led us. But the doc's called Chasing Happiness, and then the album's called Happiness Begins.
Yeah.
So you get the full kind of story and the journey that led us here, and it's just been a wild ride.
And with regards to, like, when you come to create an album and write it, is it a case of you guys will meet up and say, right, this is our writing session? Or do you kind of, if anything comes to you when you're all, like, doing your own thing, like you say, with your families and stuff, it's a case of you just jot it down, and when you get together, you say, guys, I've got this idea, I've got that.
Little notes.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of growth for all of us individually in the last 6 years and I guess 10 years of not releasing any music. So to be able to go live our lives separately and come back together, there's so many different things that we want to say in our music. So I feel like, yeah, there's definitely inspiration by our own terms, and then we bring it together and definitely collaborate.
I know you're close brothers, but the big question is, who's the favorite child?
I mean, Nick was definitely, I think.
I thought Nick might be the favorite.
Yeah, I think it could be Nick. Mm.
I mean, I don't want to agree, but I kind of agree.
Yeah.
So the documentary's out on the 4th. The new album, Happiness Begins, is out on the 7th of June. It's a pleasure to chat to you on Hits Radio. The very best of luck with it. And thank you for joining us on the show this morning.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much.
Jonas
Brothers.
Oh, yeah. This is Hits Radio Breakfast.